Okay, so welcome. It's nice to have you here. It's always a challenge to speak after Kevin John, as he is able to make his point very strong usually. But let me try to tell you a thing or two about selling Joomla to your clients, which is more or less actually the Joomla why Kevin John was talking about. So I think that's actually the right presentation in the right place. So the first point I'd like to make here is that actually you don't sell Joomla to end customers. You as a web professional, as a person who builds websites for others, you're not selling the particular technology you use to the website owners. You sell them websites. You sell them solutions to be online, to grow their business, to have websites because everyone has it. And there is like a couple of reasons why people get online. But there is, on that list of reasons, there is not a reason like, I want to have Joomla. Like that's not the way it is and that's not the way it should be. Joomla is a tool to do something, not target itself. That's why, actually, no, you shouldn't be selling Joomla to your customers, because Joomla is not for them. Joomla is for you, as a web professional, to get where your customers want you to get in a better way. So, if you think of things that a customer wants from you, I haven't been in agency business for like 2 years now, so it's been a while, but. While I was preparing this presentation, I went through the old emails and I tried to recall the conversation I had with the customers asking for websites. Some of them were, you know, a small family-owned company. Some of them were multinational corporations. So I had a chance to compare the different requests for proposals and the conversations note I had. And it occurred that they are mainly looking for things like this. So the things they are looking for, they're saying they're looking for, is either they're looking for quality, they're looking for performance, they're looking for security, they want their websites to be unique, and most of them say they want an easy way of editing content. However, I had a very nice conversation with Mike earlier today, that no matter most of them say they want to have a possibility to edit content easily, almost hardly any of them are actually doing it later on. So it is usually on the requirement list, and that's exactly how I remember it. But I also remember that we've been doing most of the works for them. Like, no matter what technology we were using to build the websites, at the very end, it was us again changing the phone number or adding the new blog post. Or sending the newsletter. That was like 80 to 90% of the cases. So those are the things that people, customers want from a website. But that's not the whole picture. There is another part of it, and it's what customers actually want from the website designing process. So what they want from a professional that will build this website for them. And that's a couple of different things. And that's obviously a good price. That's obviously a fast pace. They want this, if possible, tomorrow, if not yesterday. And they also, they don't say it, but it occurs that usually the most difficult part is actually to understand them, to get to know what they really mean by saying things. Because as Kevin John said before me, for many of our customers, internet itself and the web is not their natural place to be. Like, they are not very fluent in web and it is something new to them. So that is why they need someone who will translate from what they think they need to actually what they need. They need a translator, an interpreter that will help them to get there where they actually want to get. So that's another component that is essential in terms of good website design process. Now, so let's think of Joomla in this context. How Joomla impact the things that I've just mentioned? And let's go through it like one by one. Quality. How using Joomla for you as a person who built websites for others helps you to assure the quality is better. And when I, well, the first thing that comes into my mind is a huge project that I've been building a couple of years ago. I come from Poland, and in the previous years, we have a lot of EU money that we're spending on a lot of silly things. And one of them was a huge governmental portal that was, speaking in pounds, that was like 15 million pounds for the project itself, plus some data collection that was required for that. So one of the requirements, we're part of that, we're one of the subcontractors there, and one of the requirements was that the project itself had to have unit testing, which is not the typical thing you get on in the smaller scale. So I was very happy when one of my developers told me like, yeah, but you know, Joomla actually has all the unit tests in there. So I could easily go back to my people, to the people in the corporation that are responsible for projects, saying, yeah, we're good with Joomla. We have all the unit tests there. So this one is covered. Like, we're on the secure side here. We don't need to write everything from scratch. We don't need to do it ourselves. This requirement is can be fulfilled. So that was, for example, one case when using Joomla helped me a lot into fulfilling the requirement that was there. But it's not only that. Like, if you think of equality, it's difficult for one person or even one team of professionals to build a thing that will be especially tested in so many different cases. So using Joomla, which is a common framework tested by so many other people, a CMS on top of framework, gives you an opportunity to use something that has been tested and hardened against so many different cases. So the quality of it in general will be way better than something that a team can build. Then you have the performance. That's another typical requirement. Like, I want my website to go fast and work in a good way. So that's, again, the question, whether Joomla answers that question, and what are the, like, what are the alternatives? Because if you are a web professional, not a part of Joomla religion, you may consider other options than Joomla for a website project. So the obvious elephant in the room in terms of performance would be, for example, a static website. Like, I've known a couple of projects where they decided to go to ditch all the CMSs. And they say like, yeah, this website is not going to change actually that much. So it will be way easier to just have a couple of static HTML websites, like in the early 90s. Because this way it will be way easier to get the better performance reviews. So that's the actual real choice that we have in here. It's not only whether to use Joomla or Drupal or WordPress. It's more about, maybe I shouldn't use CMS at all. Like, if you think outside of the box, that's one of the questions you may have. So why Joomla in terms of performance? Like, why should you? And actually, I went back to my team with that question, because we've been using Joomla a lot in the agency, yes, and I was wondering, like, actually, why? With all the problems that we all know, like, why for the perform, like, what was the performance reason for that? And actually, they have shown me the performance results of the tests that we're doing at the end of the projects. Actually, I wasn't aware of that, that we were doing that at all. And it occurred that it is pretty easy to get Joomla to the 90s in the Google performance score. Of course, that's not the only thing that matters. Like that's not the only indicator, but definitely that's one of the most popular ones. And knowing what was the time pressure that I put on the team at time to build those websites and deploy them very fast, it means that it was actually out of the box pretty handy in terms of performance. If you know how to use it, and if you don't work against the mechanism but just use it on your advantage, that actually can be a performance power horse. Then security. That's of course one of the biggest debate. And what is like the other option here? Because the web professional who is not a part of Church of Joomla may think like, maybe I could suggest not a standalone solution, but a hosted solution. Maybe Squarespace or Wix or I don't know, WordPress.com, even Joomla.com, whatever. Something that is hosted. So when where security is not an issue, or at least it hasn't been an issue yet. So that's the opposition we have in here. That's where we need to think, okay, so what Joomla has to offer me here? And it is true that we have a mixed record on the security. Like Joomla has been targeted, there has been issues being found, and they are still being found, and they're being fixed. And I'm afraid that's the story that will continue. Like we will have that going on. But the thing is that what is different about open source CMSs in comparison to all those closed systems, that actually there's a lot of people trying to get in. There is a lot of people fixing those things. So of course we're writing new code, so we're making new errors, and those new errors are being used against us and stuff like this. But still, if you update Joomla website and keep it updated, it's still one of the most secure systems. And we don't know what is the track record of Wix or Squarespace, because nobody has released anything, which doesn't mean that nothing had happened. Like from time to time, we're able to hear information from like that 10 years ago, NSA was able to get somewhere, and they've been using it for 10 years without telling anyone, because why should they? Like not every hack ends up in you know, a press announcement that yeah, we've done it and we feel proud. So yes, we can see issues with both Joomla and other open source CMSs in terms of security, but at least we know where we stand. Like we know that there will be security breaches, and we know that those security breaches will be fixed. We know the manner; it's predictable. Like it's not a thing that we cannot predict, and we don't know how it actually works. So I actually think that the way that all those security issues we had are a good thing, because it shows how we work with that and how we will respond to that in the future, which increase predictability. And if you're thinking about maintaining websites, predictability is one of the most important things. Because of course, when you build new websites, it's all about new cool stuff that you can use to build it. But once it's on, it's all about sustainability. Because we need to support this website. And I really like Kevin John's idea that you need to think for no longer than 18 months. That would be perfect. But from my own experience, customers order website once every 5 years or 8 years or 10 years. And they expect that the website you have built 8 years ago will be on and will work in a certain manner, because otherwise they wouldn't buy a new website from you when the time will come. So it's a kind of a paradox that you need to have responsibility for the old stuff that has been built years ago. And in the same time, you need to have new releases that have all of this cool stuff that we want to build the new websites with. And it's exactly the same person saying those two things in the same time. But I'm getting dragged away from the security, sorry. Moving to the next point, uniqueness. Of course, I think that's one of the most popular things I see on the brief. I want something like this, but different. And yes, you can use the template that I've seen somewhere, but I want this and that changed. That's It's a pretty common thing. So speaking of uniqueness, that's where Joomla comes in handy, because you can give something that is pretty unique and still build out of building blocks that are way easier to maintain if you compared to building it from scratch on your own. You can use templates, you can use extensions. If you build something very custom, you actually can get rid of CMS itself and build it purely on framework. That's also an option. So you get a lot of things that you can put together and create a bespoke suit that appears to be actually bespoke, but in reality, it has been just adjusted in a way that it fits well. So Joomla helps us to deliver the feel of uniqueness without actually building the uniqueness on its own. Then the easy content management. Well, that's kind of an easy one, because of course there are people who argue that updating content within Joomla is not easy, or there are easier solutions to do that. But for most of our customers, it's like, I want to be able to edit something. That's what they say. And you say, yep. So you will have a possibility and say, okay, checked, no problem. There is no further discussion on that. Like, there are some rare cases when somebody says, but I would like to have WordPress because I know how to work with WordPress and I've used to work with that. Like, WordPress is kind of a popular solution, I think you've heard. So there is a chance that you'll get something like this. And in this case, sometimes it's easier to sell WordPress than to sell Joomla. However, the question is whether it will check all the other boxes you have, because there are projects where possibly WordPress can be a better solution. Like, there are also projects where a static website could be a solution, or a customly made application could be a solution. But I do believe that there is quite a few use cases where if you think of all of those things and what you get from it, it occurs that actually building it on Joomla is the winning solution. And there is one more point in here, because if you repeatedly build on something, you're becoming better and better in that. And Joomla has the ability to serve you from a pretty simple website to a pretty complex one. Meaning that if you decide to bet on Joomla, you can have 90-95% of your website built on that technology. Meaning that you will have pretty consistent scope of technologies that you need to manage and you need to master in order to build things. It's not possible with Drupal. Like, if you use Drupal, you can't actually build blocks on that. Like, it's technically possible, but from business point of view, it will never pay off. And in the same thing comes with WordPress. Like, they're putting a lot of effort to extend the high end of WordPress right now. That's true, but it's still not there. Like, there is too little in the box at the beginning to make it a feasible enterprise solution. And it means that there is a huge part in between that you can use, and betting on Joomla gives you this chance that you can have almost everything built on Joomla. Because yes, you can have an e-commerce solution based on WordPress. WooCommerce powers a lot of websites, that's true. But if any of you have ever tried to run a professional shop that has thousands or even hundreds of orders every day on WooCommerce, you know that it's not possible. Like, it is not a solution for someone who is selling professionally online. And in Joomla, it is possible to build a nicely shaped e-commerce solution. Of course, there are ready-made e-commerce platforms, those hosted and those that are self-hosted. But again, Joomla gives you the possibility to build almost everything on one technology, which helps you quickly to become an expert, and brings me to my next point, meaning that you are able to offer a good price. Because if you know the tool well, you are able to implement it fast. And if you're able to implement it fast, you're able to offer a good price and win with your competition if it's a price-based race. And you're also able to deliver it quickly, meaning that you are able to get more done in the same time, which means more money. So that's actually, for me, that was the main reason why we stay using Joomla, no matter being tempted to use WordPress or other solutions. Because once you learn one technology, you get so many benefits out of it, and it pushes your business forward, that it's a pretty easy choice for the next project. And then there's the other point, like the possibly the most difficult one, the understanding part. So this part where you are an interpreter who tries to figure out what actually it is all about. And how Joomla helps you with that, you may ask. Because Joomla is a piece of software. So it won't help you to understand the mind of other person. Well, of course it does. Because Joomla, apart from software, is also a community. And it's a community of different people coming from different places, having different mindsets, trying to do something together. And all the time you spend working within Joomla community, trying to communicate with each other, trying to understand the point of other person, their vision, their idea how to do it, actually helps you to develop the skills that are then required to build, to understand the customers and get to know what they actually want to build, what they need, what are their needs. So that's actually the one point where it's not about the software, it's about the beating heart of Joomla, so our community, because that helps us to develop those soft skills that are often in need in among technical people, and helps us to get these capabilities and serve our customers in a better way, thanks to that. So that was a couple of reasons why I think that Joomla is a good solution for a web developer, why betting on Joomla pays off, and I hope that that's the why Kevin John was missing earlier. And thank you very much for your attention. So my name is Aleksander Kuczek, and what I do when I'm not speaking or traveling, I help others to turn their web shops into, as you say in Britain, magical money trees. Thank you. Any questions? Okay, that's always the part when I wonder whether I was fully understood or not understood at all. But okay, then thank you very much for attention.